The high-speed output module keeps track of every pulse sent out independent of the main processor. That includes any pulses sent out via your project or the high-speed module test tool. You can see that here. If I enable the motor, the pulse count changes accordingly. And the only way to change that is with the home instruction or the set position instruction. We'll cover the home instruction in a separate video. Let's add a set position instruction for that channel that we were just playing with. The instruction reminds you that this channel uses this HSO module and this channel number. We'll create a structure so we can easily modify the position in the data view or ladder code. You can also use this instruction to set the backlash direction. You would typically use this to set the initial backlash direction when initializing a system. We don't need it for this demo, so we'll just leave it at no change. And you can add an instruction comment if you want to. Well, that's it. We want to be able to specify our fractional position, so let's change this to floating point. Let's add a contact so we can control that instruction and send it down to the processor. Put the processor in run mode and bring up the data view. Let's add that enable bit and the shaft position. I should mention that we're using the same hardware configuration that we used in the video on the velocity move instruction. So check that out if you want to see how we have this set up. The main thing to notice is the shaft position is in revolutions per second, not pulses. And since I've been playing with it, it's already set at this many revolutions. If we drop into the high-speed test tool, we have to stop the processor to use it. We can see that position corresponds to this many pulses. If we enable the motor, the pulse count increases. And if we exit this and re-enable the processor, the data view is updated accordingly. The key point here is every pulse that exits the HSO module, regardless of who generated it, is accounted for in this position tag. So let's add the set position structure we created to the data view and change the position to 2. To what? To revolutions. Remember, once you set up the units in the hardware configuration, everything in the entire project works in those units. The only exception to that being the high-speed test tool, which is completely independent of your project and is always in pulses. If we enable the set position command, sure enough, the current shaft position changes to 2 revolutions. And if we look at the high-speed test tool, it shows us that the unconverted pulse count, not revolutions, has also been modified accordingly. Well, that's really all there is to it. If you need any help with the Productivity Series controllers, contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning support team. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.